Hi, folks. Welcome to the Cannabis Corner. I'm your host, Kerry Burns. In our last episode, we went a little bit over the brain chemistry in the human brain and about how cannabis affects us in our brains and that we have natural cannabinoid receptor sites. And one of the key things that they look at when they put something on a controlled substance list is this ability of it to become abusable. And the reason alcohol and heroin and cocaine and cigarettes and things like that are so abusable is because they interfere with this dopamine effect going on in the brain. And for a long time, in the early 70s and stuff, when they put cannabis on the Controlled Substance Act, most of the basis of this was behavioral studies, and they thought that it followed the same pathway. Of course, when we found the cannabinoid receptor sites in the human brain and all, we knew that they were completely off base on that. And this was the reason that nobody could ever overdose. Well, these were critical reasons why they had cannabis on the Controlled Substance Act, is because of its, they thought it had a high potential for abuse. It had no medical, absolutely no medical value whatsoever, and it couldn't be used safely unless somebody was being supervised. Of course, they've disproven all that many, many times over. And then when they discovered the cannabinoid receptors, they realized that it's impossible to overdose on cannabis. And duh, guess what? Nobody ever has overdosed on cannabis. And the reason being is because the brain has this automatic shutoff response. But unlike alcohol, or heroin, or cocaine, or cigarettes, you don't have that beauty inside your brain. And the reason is because those substances inhibit this dopamine effect. And this is your reward center in your brain. I mean, when you eat something good that you like and all, the reason it tastes good to you and all is because of this dopamine response system that goes on in the brain. And when you have a substance, an illegal substance like heroin or cocaine or alcohol that should be illegal, you know, these completely go against this whole system. And once they figure that out and all, they should have actually reversed the laws on all this. Cannabis, since it doesn't follow this pathway, they've proven that it has its own receptor sites, does not interfere with the dopamine effect, and therefore we can't overdose. Then this should have been enough criterion right there to not only take cannabis off of the controlled substance, but put something like alcohol on controlled substance. Now, that's just negating all the statistics, you know, that you have to really look at. When you want to look at something in society and see how it's affecting society and whatnot, you look at the statistics, because the statistics give you an accurate handle of what's going on. And when you look at the statistics for alcohol and for cigarettes, I mean, 40 million people have died since they made cannabis illegal. And, you know, this ranges around 100,000 a year for alcohol and between 300,000 and 400,000 a year for the cigarettes and the side effects from that. If you throw in prescription drugs, add another 120,000 people a year. So between those three, the three substances that we have legal, that society says it's okay, hey, let's take a drink and all that, they think nothing about it. You tell them, hey, let's go smoke a joint, they look at you like you just stuck a needle in your arm and you're shooting up a deadly dose of heroin. This is how our society has been, and it's just insane. When you look at the statistics and all, cannabis is the Harvard Medical School director said that cannabis is the safest therapeutic substance on the planet. It's 10 times more safe than aspirin is. And if you look at the fact that 17,000 people die each year from illicit drugs, the total combined effect from all illicit drugs, heroin, cocaine, amphetamine, all of those kill less people than kills aspirin a year. So, I mean, and then we have cannabis that kills nobody, and then we have alcohol and cigarettes and prescription drugs, which take out better than 500,000 or 600,000 people a year. And does it seem right that all of the deaths that are going on in Mexico, up to 50,000 people a year that are murdered by the cartel because of the marijuana business coming into the United States? And that's what it's about. It's not about the entire drug business or anything like that. The cartels in Mexico, the reason they're fighting, they want to control the marijuana business in this country. That's what it's about. Is it worth worth the $25 billion we spend every year through the DEA to chase after cannabis? Is it worth the 50,000 people that die each year from this drug violence in Mexico? Is it worth all the thousands and thousands of people that die in this country from drug deals that have gone bad just because you got somebody that owes somebody, you know, $50 for a bag of weed and they didn't pay them and they blow their brains out? I mean, is this really what our society has come down to? Not to mention the fact of all the people that we have locked up in jail for cannabis. I mean, folks, since 1970 alone, the last 40 years, we have ruined the lives of more than 30 million people just because we chose to lock them up for pretty much using a very safe herb that statistics proved to be safe, nobody had ever died from, and yet this alcohol, it flows freely in the stores. You can buy Jack Daniels at the grocery store. Nobody cares about that 50,000 additional people die from car wrecks, from drunk drivers on the roads and stuff like that. This is all okay. But it's not okay for somebody to smoke a joint. Now, where did this insanity begin? Did we not learn from Prohibition? I mean, if you look at Prohibition, all the alcohol, the mothers were begging our government, please, 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 please make alcohol legal again, because so many of them were losing their children to bogus alcohol, methyl alcohol things. I mean, those people back there, when you have ruthless gangs controlling the illegal and illicit markets, guess what? They don't care who it hurts. They don't care if people are harmed by it or if it kills them and all. They could care less as long as they're getting their money for it. And what we're seeing today with the cannabis in Mexico is the same thing. This cartel doesn't care about human life. They just as soon kill these people as look at them. If anybody down there says, hey, I'm going to take over control of that particular bit of the business and all that, guess what? They get beheaded and then they find mass graves there around Acapulco and all along the border states and stuff. I want to ask the Drug Enforcement Agency, because y'all are the reasons this is going on and the stupid laws that we have and the stupid drug war that's already cost this country $1.5 trillion and 40 years of just this nonstop killing, and you let these gangs and stuff run everything. Is this really worth it to you? Just because people choose to get high on cannabis, a safe herb that they know they're not going to go out and do violent crime, they know they're going to not hurt somebody, they're not hurting anybody when they smoke a joint or vaporize cannabis over a vaporizer, they're not hurting anybody. And the fact that many, many people do get medicinal relief from using cannabis for a whole host of assortments. How many people do you know take alcohol for medical conditions? I mean, it's legal out there. It's everywhere. I mean, how many people do you know use alcohol for medicinal purposes? Are there any out there that you can even think of other than getting drunk and getting wasted and just forgetting about all their problems? Doesn't happen. Why is that? Why do you think that is? It's because it's a toxic substance. And you look at statistics, the statistics prove that it's toxic. The reason people are getting benefit from medical marijuana and using cannabis and stuff in their daily lives is because it is beneficial. Our brains are set up to process it. Our brains prevent us from having overdose. You can't say that about alcohol. Alcohol, when you look at the substance and what it takes you to get high on the substance versus where you get it's known as the therapeutic ratio. And alcohol, the therapeutic ratio for alcohol is like 15 times what it is for cocaine. And only heroin, dances in the same circles with alcohol. And when you look at the cannabis fact, and when you try to find the therapeutic ratio for cannabis, you have to consume 1,500 pounds of weed in 15 minutes, and that's just theoretically impossible. I can't think of anybody, if they had a bong the size of this room, they wouldn't be able to smoke that kind of cannabis in 15 minutes. You'd be lucky if you could smoke that much in an entire lifetime, and most people don't. But the fact that our society, it's okay, all of our football players, all of our sports figures and all, oh boy, they're drinking booze, man. This is such a great example to set to all of our kids. And people, when you talk to them about cannabis and stuff, they say, oh, we're worried about our children getting a hold of it. Well, what you should be worried about is them turning into alcoholics or smoking cigarettes or taking prescription drugs. Actually, if you really were worried about them and you knew they were going to do something, you should be praying that they actually smoke the cannabis. I hope that they don't have to do anything, but if they choose to go down that path. Make sure that they choose the safe path. Educate them. Educate them to the dangers that how many people die from these substances every year, and the fact that nobody dies from cannabis. I mean, statistics don't lie. You can't circumvent the facts when it comes to statistics. And these are statistics that are put out by our government. If anybody had a chance to manipulate the facts and figures and stuff, it would be them. And they, in their statistics, say nobody's ever died from cannabis. And the reason they say that unequivocally is because nobody ever has. It's impossible. The brain will not allow it. Sorry to say, though, it doesn't happen with the alcohol, folks. And if we're going to have this substance legal, if we're going to have stuff like cigarettes legal, and that people can go and get prescription drugs and take them like they're going out of style and all that, we have no business arresting people for cannabis. In fact, we should be encouraging people to use cannabis to keep them from getting hooked on stuff like this, because this stuff is deadly. It is deadly. It will take you out. It will cause cirrhosis of the liver. It will kill you. That has never happened with the cannabis before. Wake up, America. I mean, statistics prove this. It's right there in front of your face. And for you to go on day to day with this facade of, oh, marijuana's dangerous and all that, you're ignorant. You're not listening to the facts. You just honestly have just the fact that you it's okay for this substance like alcohol to be illegal. You should be giving marijuana away to every citizen out there that's a tax-paying citizen. I mean, that's the whole joke of the whole thing. And the DEA, the only reason it exists is because that's their job, is to chase after the cannabis. Folks, get real. Honestly, get real. Look at statistics. Look at the dangerous substances that we have legal in this country. There is no reason why we should have any laws against cannabis at all. It should not be controlled in any way. And most of all, more than anything, we need to get the hemp industry growing so we can get this country out of its economic doldrum. This is one industry that we can do here in this country and have drastic effects on unemployment, drastic effects on our society, drastic effects on the environment, the whole bit. Wake up, people. Wake up. Don't be fooled by the lies out there. Cannabis is safe. Illicit drugs are safer than anything we've got legal whatsoever. In this stupid drug war, it's enough's enough. DEA, go get another job. Your days are done of lying to the American public and making up all these lies about cannabis that you know as soon as they came out of your mouth, you know they weren't true. And I thank every one of you for spending time in the Cannabis Corner.